All right, it's been 24 hours sitting next to a heater. So let's go ahead and see the results. Last time I saw it, it was green, kind of a little starting to turn brown, but that was it. I have not popped this lid since. Let's get some light on the subject, if it'll extend. Head into the charger there. A little black residue. Yeah. So, it did leave the black residue, as some said. At least the rust is off. I guess what I'll do is I'll go ahead and wash this off. And then clean it and stuff like that. And then we'll get it back and we'll see about breaking the links. Well, here it is after cleaning, scrubbing with Dawn dish soap, pat dry. And some areas look really nice. The camera doesn't really pick it up as good. There's not black residue. Some parts that were heavily rusted have a little bit. But what I will note is links that were initially somewhat free enough when I during the bending process that were difficult are now really easy to maneuver. As you can see, I'm not struggling here. Some of them seem like they're freeing up more than others. And then some are still kind of if, but as you can see, I think it can be saved. I got one right here. And it turns. That'll have to be one of those hammered ones. And then you got others that turn just really nicely. So, areas that look like they weren't really of high rust or anything. Probably was inside the curve of the saw. So the weather and everything didn't get to it immediately. Versus other parts that were on the bar that saw all rain and all weather. At least what I'm going to assume, you know. Hey, that's good enough to stick on the saw, right? We'll just stick it on there and make the saw power through all 120 cc's of American power. So now we've got some kinks to work out. And how I'm going to do that, I haven't got a 100% plan on it yet. I know a hammer, maybe some wood or something sacrificial to tap or, you know, whatever. I got a brass hammer down here. I might be able to use it a little bit to tap some of the links, put it in a vise or something. Yeah, this area here. Some of them are going to hammer out real nicely and quickly for me. Some may not, but we'll have to stick it over something and just hammer away at it. So I'll have to figure that out. Yeah, see? And it frees up. And then after it frees up, it gets easy. I mean, it feels like it's a little gooey, like if you had, you know, dry syrup or something in there, I guess. Old bar oil, dry syrup. That's what that kind of feels like. Nothing a little lubricant can't handle, so I need to figure a way to set this up and just go through and tap each one back to life. So, let me get that sorted, and we will be back and probably do one heck of a time lapse of going through this, and hopefully she'll be about ready and should be as malleable as the other chain that I've got, which actually looks like it's for a 24-inch bar. So all hope wouldn't be lost. If this 5/8 doesn't work immediately, we have the other 5/8. Stay tuned. Not sure how well you can see this, but kind of thought about a technique like this. Hopefully you can see this, because I can't see that. I'm kind of just going through and pulling on it. Any links, just doing a manual free up by hand first. Stretching, move a little bit, stretching some more, freeing up whoever wants to free up. And then I'll start the whoever doesn't want to free up process. So kind of figured we'll try this out, see what works, see what we can break up. Because once it breaks up, it becomes very, very malleable, very easy. Just kind of see how much it's already freeing up. Couldn't do that before. I think it was as stiff as a 2x4. So just going through and doing this to start freeing up anybody. And then we'll get the stubborn ones, maybe with some lubricant. So. All right. A little sweat on the glasses. Went around. And, you know, manually broke it. A few of them. I had the vise up here. I took it down. Tapping it around and stuff like that. And it is starting to display qualities of chain. Some are still stiff and some are still, you know, kind of froze. This section right here is wanting to be a little bit of a fighter. But overall it is trying to act like a chain again. Like I said, this section right here. So, I did break up the section, a lot of it. You can see, there, like you see the rust. So that's areas that are broke up all the way around it. So what we're going to do is we're going to dip this back in the evaporust for a few more hours. And we're gonna repeat this process. We're gonna dip, break, and go from there and repeat it, the evaporust as necessary. Penetrating fluid, it's gonna get it wet, but our enemy is the rust right now. So you can oil this up and that's just going to make it into an oily mess. We need to eliminate the rust that's causing the issues in between each one. And the only thing that's going to do that to really dissolve it is the evaporust. So we'll toss it back in there. And we'll go ahead, let's sit a few more hours. And we'll be back after that. Alright, a couple hours later, and we'll see how well things have come along here. Rather than a tangled up mess, moving a lot better. So I'll go do another scrub and bring you back. Alright, rinsed off. Now, you remember me saying something about flash rusting? This is flash rusting. That's how quick it takes over. But that's not going to bother us too much. Our goal is still break these links. Now, most of them are coming down to the point where you break it, and it once it's broke, it stays. It's just, it accepts it. It accepts going back to being a normal chain. So that's kind of what I'm doing here now, is finding the ones that are not broken and I'm just breaking them. And then there's some that are still going to just be stubborn and I'm going to have to hammer on them. Or because I've got a 12 ton press outside, I've been thinking of ways how to utilize it to put a little pressure to break them, like this one right here. It absolutely wants to be stubborn, so I was thinking about going outside to the press and gently pressing on it to where once it breaks, it'll be nice to me. And then once it's broken everything, like some of these that are, you know, like this one right here, then you can add lubricant. And then it'll just be good, because that it ain't gonna get any looser. So, going through that process now, finding who, seeing if I can hand break them, and then going from there. Yeah, see, that one right there just broke free, and now it just turns wonderfully. So, that's what I'm going through the process of, trying to see who's gonna give it up to me now, or who wants to fight the press. So, that's the tedious process I'm after. Probably sure there's one of you like, I don't know, there's an easier way, Brian. Leave it in the comments. I'd be lovely, lovely happy to hear, because this is definitely my first or my last rodeo of doing this. I tried to break one in the past, so I guess I could say this is my first, but this ain't gonna be my last rodeo of doing this. Yeah, see, that section right there is just absolutely horrible to try to break. So I'm gonna continue trying breaking them. If I do go to the press, I will take you along with me for the ride. It's cold outside, so we'd be next to a heater, or possibly wait till morning. So we'll find out. All right, let's see if I get this on camera. I've kind of developed a technique. So the ones that show rust are free. This link, this connection right here is not. This one is. See? So what I'm having to do, I'm re-quotes freezing this connection right here with the pliers. And having to beat this one down to break these. I know a hammer, ouch, but. All right, there, broke it. And then I gotta take it up so either I can try to grip it and move it or I get the hammer. Depending on how stuck it really wants to be. Or if the pliers hold their spot. Okay, see, it's at an angle now. So now that it's like that, and we're straightening it. At the spot. That re-breaking it. Hit it that way. Taking it that way. And now I take the lubricant, just a spray of it. Putting it in there. Small hammer. Small. Take it back on a flat surface. That way, and we're just repeating it. There it goes. Oh yeah, there we go. So that's how I've developed breaking the links. Painfully breaking them. Less pain using towel. There we go. So what was frozen moments ago is now free. And I just work it a little bit more lubricant into it. Once the rust breaks, helps wash it out and lubricate slightly. There we go. And just keep working it for a few minutes. And once you feel it's good, on to the next. On to the next. I'd say about half of them are broke free and happy. Easily half. Maybe 60-65%. Most of them are kind of like this right now. Where you have a series of them that are good. And then you have one that is stubborn in the bunch. And it wants to be a bit of a pain. But I developed that technique there. It's the best I had. Free the old girl up. So that's the pain I've been going through. So, like I say, just keep at it. Like I say, there ain't much life left in the teeth, but to make one cut with this. And to keep it for show, I think it'll be worth it. So, anybody got 5/8 chain? This is Oregon. This is Oregon 5/8 has a 17 on the drive link. So, got any, let me know. Alright, it's been a week since I've touched the chain. What I've done is I put it in a trash bag with PB Blaster's multi-purpose lubricant to help wash things out and stuff, help get in between the links even better. You know, penetrating wood fluid do, but I also want the oil aspect. So it's a mess in there, dirty, everything I would presume. So I did set up something to help, as you saw right there, the vise. I have mounted it to the table using T-screws underneath that go into the wood. So it's removable, really quickly removable. 9/16 on the mini impact. And a bar and chain. An old hard nose that I have. And what I plan to do is use this as the curvature. I don't know why I didn't think of this earlier. But use it as the curvature and be able to beat the chain that wants to stay straight. I could use the bar here to beat it down. Now, I've thought about, you know, I could put it up higher. I could cut the bar because this nose, the hardened part of it, which is, from what I've read, it's called the studite. And it's the hardened, welded part. And some guys back in the day would get the whole length of it done. And it wasn't cheap then. And the studite, the hard part, is completely gone on the nose of this. There's just little remnants left. So this bar is wore out on the nose. So I didn't see it as really going to be too much of a loss when it come to things. Trying to beat things down, it may need a hole drilled into it somewhere and a bolt run through so it doesn't move. Like I said, I could cut it, mount it in the vise somehow, stuff, but I didn't really want to cut it right now. So we'll kind of work with what we've got on this and everything and go from there. So, but this is not the chain, but this is the chain we're, you know, same type that we're going to be using. And as you can see, it fits over it. So it'll work for that. That's what we're going for, is a chain that does that. It had been a week. I looked back real quick, and the last thing I remember asking was anybody had 5/8 chain. So, and the patent number on this is 2622636. So, if anybody ever wanted to know that, at least that one. So, without further ado, we'll get inside this bag full of deliciousness. And it's, of course, an oiled up mess. Does move, thankfully. About the same as last time. Get that. Try to keep that mess over there. As you can see, it doesn't really display all the characters of a moving chain, so that's kind of something we'll have to do, and that was part of the idea of hitting it down, moving it, hitting it, stuff like that, so. Kind of forcefully conform it to the bar here. Now, being able to hold some of them down is another question, you know. See how it wants to pivot on the one. So, it's kind of another one of those, if I could be able to figure out a clamp. Doesn't really like it being turned too much because the chain hits the desk here. But also, it's stiff. So, that's kind of the plan. And working with what I got. Being creative. So I'll figure something out. It can hold, and then we'll go from there. Probably a good pair of vise grips. I had a bigger set. Slip in there and clip, and then hit it down. Rinse, repeat. Labor of love kind of stuff. Yeah. I don't know if I have a pair big enough for that exact setup. It is a huge chain. How big can we go? By George, it fits.
We'll zoom in a little bit, since it is a little bit of a distance away.
A little bit of smoke come from that because it did not like it, so. There we go. So we'll just have to keep doing that for each stubborn link.
Shall we?
I'm gonna time lapse. And for the straight portions, of course, we've got the straight part of the bar, and I can do that on that side too. Just tap it on the
straight side on the other side, possibly that side too. So, without further ado, we'll see how far I get here.
Well, progress to this point. So, area is still stiff, still breaking it up, but got about a third of the chain done, breaking links. And some of them are, like say, are stiff on the straight spots after coming over there, but they'll work it out. So, working the hammer. Keep at it. And yeah, I'm listening to music on the tablet, but obviously I can't put that on YouTube. Because let's face it, silence is not going to be good. So, we're getting there. Look at that monster. This part of the bar is really wore down, so when it comes to getting inside the groove, it kind of... Just working it. Just keep on working it. Determination, right?
Whoa.
There, alright. So I've been at this for a couple hours. Pliers and hammer. And I think this chain is honestly going to be saved. Most of the links are freed up. A lot of them are still stiff in areas. And I'll work on the individual little ones off camera and everything. But in the majority of things, you guys remember how stiff the chain was and everything. Now we've got, and there are still some stiff areas. It doesn't like that. So here, zoom in on it and everything, get the best I can, because the vice mounting area, and kind of takes two hands to do some of it. As you can see, other than wanting to slide off, we've got pretty much the majority of it, and it stays flat on a lot of it. And everything, and then some of it just has a little more rust, like we're coming up on that. So you're going to see there's some areas that are still stiff, but I'm not putting much tension. And they do move, and those are the ones I'm going to work on individually, whatever. Like this section right here, still a little stiff in a lot of spots, but it does move. This guy right here still being really stubborn. That link right there. So. So it's got a stiff on that rivet right there. I'll show you here real quick. Try to show. See? It moves. It is free. It isn't frozen anymore. Then when we come down to the flat side over here, this is what I've been doing. Just back and repeating that process for 2 hours. So, pretty sure the saw will help free up some of them, but that's what I'm going to do off camera. So, is the chain saved? Like I said, I think yes. Can we save it? You bet. You know, for novelty purposes, sheer size of showing how big chain used to be and how far we've come in chain technology. Always an unfrozen one. So, get past that. See? Just stiff in a lot of spots. And this area is still pretty stiff right here when it comes to it, but it does go around the curve. Like I say, a couple of them. That rivet right there, just a little. So. But overall, and then we're back to that where we started. So, yeah, I think the chain is definitely saved or will be here real soon. But I just don't want to wear this on or anything, so. Show you guys that. So. Alright, that's what I want to say. Thanks for watching this little video series on Can We Save This? And as for the bar, I'm thinking I'm going to leave the patina on the sides of it and clean out the rail. And we'll just go from there on it because it just looks pretty good. So, say thanks for watching. And once again, big thanks to David for the Evaporust. And we still have to use it on a few other things and whatnot. So, it isn't the end of the Evaporust. We'll get the series. And the guy is getting the crankshaft and parts shipped out to me. So, we will hopefully be assembling this thing real soon and hearing it. I've got gaskets already cut out and whatnot, so. But I'm just rambling on now. So, thanks for watching.